Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Please stand for the singing of our national anthem, and please remain standing as we honor our Aboriginal heritage with an honor song by Joseph Harper, who is Cree from the Bear Clan. Thank you, Joseph. Please take your seats. On behalf of George Brown College, I would like to welcome you all, graduates, family, and friends, to this afternoon's convocation exercises for the class of 2012. My name is Georgia Quartaro, Acting Vice President Academic and Dean of the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies, and it is my pleasure to serve as your Master of Ceremonies today. Our convocation ceremony today is taking place on the traditional lands of the Mississaugas of New Credit. I would like now to introduce the members of our platform party. I'll ask them to stand and remain standing as they are introduced, and I ask that you please hold your applause until the end of the introductions. It is my particular pleasure to introduce Sally Horsfall Eaton, newly appointed as the first chancellor of George Brown College. From the Board of Governors of George Brown College, Sue Herbert. From George Brown College, Ann Sato, President of the College, Eugene Harrigan, Vice President, Corporate Services, Karen Thompson, Vice President, Marketing and Strategic Enrollment Management, Diane Tessier, Registrar, Maureen Loweth, Dean for the Center of Business Arts and Design, and Brenda Pipitone, Dean of Academic Services and Student Affairs. I would also like to acknowledge our elder in residence, Pauline Shirt, who is Cree from the Red Tail Hawk clan, originally from Saddle Lake, Alberta. Our keynote speaker this afternoon is Patty Harrington, who will be more formally introduced later in the program. And finally, the staff and faculty of the Center for Arts and Design, the Center for Continuous Learning, and the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies. All stand, please. Please take your seats. This afternoon, we are recognizing graduates from the School of Fashion Studies, the School of Performing Arts, and the School of Design in the Center for Arts and Design, graduates from the Center for Continuous Learning, and graduates from the School of Liberal Arts and Sciences in the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies. Our interpreters this afternoon are Monique Ledrew and Tara Everett, and our captioner is Joanne Anderson. As Dean of the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies, I want to congratulate all the graduates. Graduation is one of the days you had in mind when you started college, at moments when you knew you were going to be successful, and perhaps at moments when you weren't sure how or even if this was all going to work out. Learning is lifelong. You have been learning since before you were born and will continue to learn all your lives. However, being a student is a time of special focus and preparation. It has been a chance to develop skills, to think critically, to consider new ideas. Some of you are ready to pursue the careers for which you have prepared. Others are looking ahead to further education first. I hope that you value and have enjoyed the learning in all your studies. They all contribute to the best of education, to being able to think clearly, to feel deeply, and to act wisely. I congratulate you on what you have achieved and wish you success. I will now call upon Dean Maureen Loweth from the Center for Business, Arts, and Design to address the graduates and to introduce our keynote speaker. Thank you, Georgia.
Madam President, Madam Chancellor, distinguished guests, esteemed colleagues, family and friends of graduates, It is my pleasure to extend congratulations to all of our graduates today. I speak on behalf of your many professors and other staff members who are here today to show their support for your accomplishments. And like your family and friends who join you today at this ceremony, we're very proud of what you've achieved and happy to have been part of your education at George Brown College. You've gained knowledge and skills to position you for employment in some of the key sectors of Toronto and the city region. Now it's time to use your personal skills like determination and persistence to make the transition to the world of work. We hope that you think back fondly on your time at George Brown and that you'll stay connected as alumni to the important work that we do here at George Brown on behalf of students. Today, you follow in the footsteps of 44 years of George Brown College graduates. You are joining over 200,000 alumni who are making a name for themselves around the world. And as you embark on your careers and in the years ahead, I urge you to look for opportunities to do business with other George Brown graduates and to stay connected with the George Brown community. Today, I also have the pleasure of introducing our keynote speaker, Patty Harrington. Patty is the Executive Creative Director at Bruce Mau Design in Toronto. BMD is a design and innovation studio that works with organizations in a number of fields, and these include culture, commerce, media, and education. Their teams in Toronto and New York have a broad base of talent who are graphic designers, architects, technologists, animators, writers, strategists, and producers. And these teams provide global clients like Coca-Cola, the city of Mecca in Saudi Arabia, and the Museum of Biodiversity in Panama with ideas and plans to transform how they think, talk about themselves, and appear in the world. Patty has a very interesting academic and business background, and I'd like to tell you just a little bit about that. He is educated in the fields of literature and architecture. His undergraduate degree is in English literature from the University of Ottawa, and his master's degree is in architecture from the University of Toronto. He has an innate understanding of arts and design and their impact on our lives. From the branding that characterizes the fashion world, to the drama that is found in theater and dance, to the exquisite craftsmanship required of jewelers and gemologists, and to the strategy and creativity in the design field. Patty understands the thread that links all of these, making a more meaningful life. Patty's career started in research, moved to architecture, and then to advertising and design. He's an award-winning writer and filmmaker and speaks regularly at design conferences around the world. There's one line in his bio that I especially like, which is that he is, quote, obsessed with finding meaningful stories that help drive positive change. Nearly 10 years ago, the School of Design at George Brown College started a graduate certificate program called the Institute Without Boundaries. And we did this in partnership with Bruce Mau and the Bruce Mau Design Studio. This interdisciplinary design program offers students the opportunity to work as a team, to research, design, and realize a public research project. Our collaboration with BMD was the research and execution of a major exhibition that was showcased at both the Art Gallery of Ontario in Toronto and the Vancouver Art Gallery, and it was called Massive Change. The school has also had the benefit of having Patty Harrington as a thesis mentor in the graphic design program. And he's also a member of the Institute Without Boundaries Program Advisory Committee. In this volunteer role, he provides advice on curriculum and reviews student work. Patty has also hired many of our graduates to work at the BMD studio, recognizing GBC's capacity to create employment-ready graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a leader in the field of design and innovation who has distinguished himself in business and in his generous volunteer activities with George Brown College and our students. Our keynote speaker for this afternoon, Patty Harrington.
Madam President, Madam Chancellor, members of the Platform Party, members of the graduating class, ladies and gentlemen. I want to talk about two things today, purpose and passion. Today you're looking in two different directions, backwards but forwards as well. On the one hand, you're looking back and reflecting on the experiences you've gained throughout this education. On the other hand, you're looking forward to the next thing that you'll do. But right now, in this moment, you're looking both forward and backward at the same time between two significant phases in your life. And that's a special thing. It happens only a few times in a lifetime, and it's a moment that will define you, depending on how you look at it. If you think about it as an ending, then you will think about your future as a set of tasks. Get your resume ready, search for a job, go to job interviews, get a job, get a promotion, advance your career. But if you think about this moment as the continuation of something you started a long time ago, then you will think about your future as the unfolding of a bigger story. It's the unfolding of your purpose. Some of you here have found your purpose and know exactly what it is that drives you. Some will be obsessing over finding their purpose, frantically searching for it everywhere. And others may think that you don't really need purpose. What you need right now is a job, and that's true. But for those who have found it, they'll tell you that in the long run, purpose is what sustains you. It's what gives you that deep drive. Jobs, titles, salary, that all changes over time, but your purpose will always be the source of your true satisfaction. The funny thing about purpose, though, is that it's hard to find. But chances are, if you're like me, your purpose has always been right in front of you, but you're too close to it. It's such a deep part of you that you simply cannot see it anymore. The trick is uncovering it, but it'll never show up if you don't look for it. My own search for purpose has been circuitous. I studied literature, then I wandered around aimlessly. I worked in broadcasting, I worked at a bank. I didn't know where I was going, but I obsessed about finding my purpose. I decided to pursue architecture, and I studied it. Then I worked in the field. I still didn't know where it was all heading, but I kept on searching for the answer to the question, what am I meant for? How do we really find our purpose? I'm a believer that passion is an indicator of purpose. If designers approach me with work that they're genuinely passionate about, then it's a good sign that the work itself will be great. But this is not loud, chest-thumping, overflowing passion. By passion, I mean a sort of deep calm, a kind of conviction. It's hard to notice, especially in yourself, but it's very hard to beat. This kind of intuitive passion is a good indicator for you in your own search. If you find yourself working on something that you simply just can't stop doing because you have this deep feeling that it's just right, then the chances are that you're on to your passion and your purpose. For me, I found Bruce Mau Design. It's a company at the intersection of two things I'd always had a passion for, but never thought that could really add up to a serious job. And those two things are storytelling and design. Once I found that moment or this place, then things started to become easy for me. When you find what you love, things become easy, and you will have found your purpose, and that's where you'll find your satisfaction. Now, I didn't say happiness. Life is hard. I work like crazy, probably too much. But when you find your passion, it doesn't feel like work. It feels like satisfaction. In some ways, you have to keep moving until you find that what you're doing does not feel like work. Learn to recognize your intuitive passion and use it as a guide. Let it lead you to your next move. Remove the obstacles between yourself and those passions. Identify the things you could do next to help you reach your purpose and then act on it. Ask yourself, what is the most bold thing that you could do right now? Move to Paris, start your own company. That's the magic of this moment. You are looking backward at what inspires you and looking forward at a brand new phase of your life. Even if you fail, you will have learned. If you move to the city you've dreamed about your whole life and find that you have to move right back home, you will have learned something. But if you succeed, if you fight through diversity and challenge and use your ingenuity to find success, it will have been worth it, I can guarantee it. You will have written a new chapter in your own story. So tomorrow, let yourself dream about the most amazing ways that you can realize your passion and your purpose. But today, right now, enjoy a rare moment of satisfaction that is not an ending, but just your next beginning. Thank you.
Thank you, Patty. Ladies and gentlemen, we have now come to the part of today's ceremony in which we recognize outstanding scholastic achievement by our graduates. At this time, we would like to recognize the recipient of the Governor General's Academic Medal. This medal was first awarded in 1873 by the Earl of Dufferin and has since become one of the most prestigious awards that a student in a Canadian educational institution can receive. The Collegiate Bronze Medal from the Governor General of Canada is awarded to the student in a 2 or 3 year program with the highest cumulative grade point average. This year, the recipient of the Governor General's Academic Medal is Jennifer Rodriguez Allen from the Activation Coordinator Gerontology Program in the School of Health and Wellness in the Center for Health Sciences. Jennifer will receive her award at convocation ceremony on Wednesday, June 13th, but I'd like to ask you to join me in congratulating her now. We would now like to recognize the recipient of the Board of Governors Medal. The Board of Governors Medal was established in 2007 when the first degree programs graduated from George Brown College. The medal is awarded to a full-time student in a degree program of at least 4 years' duration and is awarded for academic excellence to the student with the highest cumulative grade point average. This year, the recipient of the Board of Governors Medal is Candy McKinnon, who is graduating with a Bachelor of Applied Business in Financial Services from the School of Financial Services in the Center for Business. Candy will receive her award at her convocation ceremony this evening. But again, I ask you to join me in a round of applause for this high-achieving student. This afternoon, we are proud to honor a graduate from the Center for Arts and Design with a Dean's Award to recognize both high academic achievement across all semesters within the center and contributions to the college community. I would like to call on Dean Maureen Loweth to come forward to present this award. This year, the recipient of the Dean's Award for the Center for Arts and Design is Rachel Guggen. Rachel is a graduate of the Fashion Techniques and Design program in the School of Fashion Studies. Rachel, would you please come forward to accept your award?
Maybe you can turn so you can get it. Okay. Thank you.
Now it is my pleasure to introduce the valedictorian for this afternoon. Jennifer Johnson is a graduate of the Fashion Techniques and Design program in the School of Fashion Studies in the Center for Arts and Design. Jennifer, will you please come forward to address the graduating class of 2012?
Good day, everybody. Madam Chancellor, Madam President, members of the Platform Party, fellow graduates, George Brown faculty and staff, and ladies and gentlemen, I feel both privileged and proud to be standing here today, representing George Brown Center for Arts and Design, Education Assistant Program, and School of Liberal Arts and Sciences graduating class of 2012. And I am grateful that you could all be here today to share in our celebration. Together, we have had quite the journey, and as travel writer Tim Cahill once said, a journey is best measured in friends rather than miles. I am pleased that friendships we have developed over these past years will forever reflect the incredible adventure that we have shared. As we have helped each other grow and overcome various obstacles, we also have many others to thank for the encouragement and determination given to us to even attempt the lofty goals we set out to achieve. People like our family, our friends outside the college, and the faculty that traveled the beaten path with us and inspired us to keep moving forward despite any doubts we may have had along the way. I, for one, am unable to thank our instructors and mentors enough for the invaluable life lessons we've learned. I can honestly say that I consider many of my teachers to be friends that I hope to confide in into the future. Being a student, you come to understand it is not required for the teachers to concern themselves with your progress or to take time outside the classroom to help you understand or advance your own thirst for knowledge. We have been extremely lucky to have experienced an education with the faculty that we have at George Brown today, and for that I say thank you. As I look back on my time here with George Brown College and reflect on what I have learned in our courses, I appreciate the work and steps we've taken to get here. There were times, I'm sure, we have all wondered if we could do this, even thought, I can't do this. Many of us have had jobs along with classes. Some of us came back as mature students, some with families, and still others with English as a second language. Some even dealt with more serious issues, like health crises and personal losses. And yet there was no struggle we did not overcome to be here today. So for any of us that have ever thought, I can't do this, let's take a moment and look where we are. And for those that want to pursue further education and wonder if they can do it, I want you to look where you are now. You can do it. You've already done it once. This is our moment, your moment, and we will cherish these memories forever. As we take the time to celebrate today with family and friends, we must remind ourselves that the adventure is just beginning. Don't spend so much time trying to choose the perfect opportunity that you miss the right opportunity. Recognize that there will be failures and acknowledge that there will be obstacles. But know that you will learn from your mistakes and the mistakes of others, for there is much to be gained from experiencing failure. To my fellow graduates, always remember your achievements with pride. Throughout the years, you have set goals and met each challenge with enough courage and determination to overcome the many obstacles you've encountered along the way. Success is not measured by how well you fulfill the expectations of others, but by how you honestly live up to your own expectations. Success is not a place at which one arrives, but rather the spirit with which one undertakes and continues the journey. Because you have been true to yourself in the pursuit of your dream, you have earned this moment and the right to be proud of your accomplishment. Good luck and thank you. Congratulations, everybody.
We have now reached the formal part of our ceremony, where we award the credentials, the diplomas and certificates, and these become official documents of the college. I invite Chancellor Sally Horsfall Eaton to come forward, and would the graduates please stand. Madam Chancellor, it is my privilege to report to you that all the candidates assembled here today have qualified in all respects for their credentials by successfully completing curricula offered by the Center for Arts and Design, the Center for Continuous Learning, and the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies at George Brown College. Faculty members have recommended that they be awarded their credentials in recognition of their academic accomplishments.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Governors of George Brown College, I do hereby confer on you your respective diplomas and certificates with all the rights and privileges and responsibilities pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Madam Chancellor, on behalf of all the graduates not present, I request that you confer their credentials in absentia.
I so do, and congratulations to them as well. Thank you.
Thank you. Graduates, please take your seats. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, during the next part of the ceremony, we will be presenting the graduates individually to Chancellor Sally Horsfall Eaton and President Ann Sado. To show our respect for each graduate, we ask that you remain in your seats until the last graduate has received his or her credential. We also ask that you withhold your applause until all the graduates from each program have been presented so that we can hear everyone's name. For our graduates, upon receiving your credential, we ask that you return to your seats and enjoy the rest of the convocation program. Madam Chancellor, Madam President, I wish to present the graduates from the Center for Arts and Design, the Center for Continuous Learning, and the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies so that you may confer their credentials. I will ask our announcer, Patrick Kwok-Chun, to come to the podium now.
Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Center for Arts and Design, School of Fashion Studies, from the Fashion Management Program, Fatima Ali. Stephanie Almeida. Emily Angela Alonzi. Alma Lucila Anser. Anna Michaela Antonio. Giovanna Alexandra Arcos. Sabrina Elizabeth Brownie. Allison Brunt. Christina Callery. Lauren Claveau. Precious Christine Clement. Suzette A. Corey. Sandra Dalmas. Tanya Dallaire Langlois. Natasha Lynn Durwarder. Caitlin Duffield. Catherine Elizabeth Dugas. Catherine L. Dupuis. Tiffany Kimberly Fanima. Ingrid Giselle Garcon Lozano. Lauren Michelle Gillis. Hannah Gao. Jessica Amy Goubert. Sarah Hamilton. Mohammed Nazumul Haik. Bushra Hassan. Bethany Ho. Haley Noel Houston. Lindsay Johnson. Paige Kay. Trudy Ann Kirby. Chiara Lombardo. Natasha Kathleen Lawless. Catherine Ashley Lazaroff. Dominique Lee. Sarah Diane Litherland. Candice Ellen Lucien. Diane Lee. Stephanie Markoulakis. Alexandra Joy McFadden. Kristen Jo Ellen McKinnon. Whitney Lauren Morris. Amanda Roxanne Mullings. Sanem Mustafa. Doan Nguyen. Hankyol Oh. Hui Uyang. Lisa Catherine Packin. Beatrix Pritchard Pawsey. Erin Nicole Polsky. Michelle Courtney Kwan. Hilary Jane Radford. Daniel Schmidt. Shawnee Subira Scott. Maya Sheffield. Amanda Bozena Stipic. Ferris Cobb Stone. Michelle C. Yoon Su. Ryan Tartaglio. Jody Taylor. Krista Catherine Tosello. Maggie Tran. Dominique Christina Washington. Stephanie Lee Wilden. April Wilder. Mingzon Yan. Emily Young. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Gemmanology program. Colin Stewart Brady. Maria Cherkaskaya. Lita Ko-Woon Jung. Ji-Yoon Kim. Abdul Aziz Mohammed. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Jewelry Methods Program. Sun Ho Che. Carlene Marguerite DeRigo. Kibum Annabelle Hun. Hui Huin. Hoi In Kim. Sumi Ko. Carrie Person Christie. Darija Radic. Yui Shiozawa. Stephanie Ton Tsoi. Tayanda Tyson. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Jewelry Essentials Program. Nancy Nancy. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Fashion Business Industry Program. Nikita Marie Armsby. Bianca Ostini. Monique Francis Chu. Danielle Nicole Davis. Alicia DiPaolo. Chelsea Downs. Matthew Edward Dyer. Patrick Leone Ewing. Jessica Lynn Gradwell. Genevieve Chantel Hutchinson. Dora Kuhar. Rachel Anna Lal. Emily Marion McDonald. Melissa Cecile Markovich. Alexandra Martin. Michelle McCoy. Yelimberhan Matikia. Faye Millen. Taylor Marie Robinson. Shauna Ashley Sanichar. Mayna Song. Linda Chen. Yen San Wu Wu. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Fashion Techniques and Design Program. Seyede Rana Agay Lagay. Rose Cao. Christina Carreri. Sarah Chalumnicek. Janae Alicia Charles. Pui Yi Chung. Diana Chong. Robin Chong. Danielle Alexandra Connor. Desiree Degar. Veronica Dolganova. Marissa Shoshona Engels. Jacqueline Doreen Gilby. Sarah Toby Goldberg. Mallory Rose Gosselin. Sarah Lorenza Guarnacha. Rachel Elizabeth Gogan. Imka Sandra Hanscom. Paris II Hassanpour Kasebnia. Ray Kiong Hong. Sarah Jean Horn. Rita Ito. Jennifer M. Johnson. Bomi Kim. Yu Jin Kwan. Jamie Louise Lard. Emily Ma. Charisse Erica Manalung. Paola Markelli. Deli Mazat. Jessica Meneses. Carmen Ng. Amanda Rochelle Nickel. Amarina Providence Norris. Jessica Janice Noseworthy. Michael Anthony Palak. Dayo G. Park. Aye Sharudi. Nina Taylor. Zonke Ajimov Waka. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Jewelry Arts Program. Erica Diener. Atusa Gavami. Vanessa Ray. Ga Young Cindy Young. Victoria Yez. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the International Fashion Development and Management Program. Briona L. Bernastowski. Laura Camacho. Maria Camisso. Allison Corrigan. Roni Dinath. Ashley Dupuy. Guramrit Kaur. Unila Chesia Melissa. Sydney Moore. Morgan Stephanie Rock. Rachel Victoria Jane Rowland. Alina Tarani. Joyce Tai. Shelby Lynn Walker. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Theater Arts School of Performing Arts program. Jeffrey Bruce Stewart Dingle. Hillary Ann Scott. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Dance Performance Preparation Program. Joanna Catherine Keats. Hillary McDuff. Sarah Sequeira. Victoria Patricia Stewart. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Dance Performance Studies Program. Mallory Jane Belzil. Samantha Farragio. Sarah Marie Helps. Kirsty Keenan. Leora Paige Kirschenblatt. Marcy Jane Masari. Samantha Lee Smith. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Commercial Dance Studies Program. Delaney Heather Burke. Stephanie Brinning. Jerry Burchill. Kristen Dawn Long. Bronwyn Kayla Ruth Stanowski. Natasha Marie Valentine. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Center for Arts and Design, School of Design, Graphic Design Program. Amy Marie Alacock. Mazda Amir Yar. John Lawrence Barris. Evan Borthwick. Miranda Elizabeth Boland. Deanne Buerano. Kevin Cabral. Slade Elliott Carter. Sewa Cha. Victor Cheris. Courtney Cho. Kay Lee Chu. Daniel Fitzpatrick Clark. Mark Robert Cormier. Michael David Crook. Petra Kushkiri. Erin Nicole DeCosimo. Jonathan Ciro Delgado. Victoria Nicole Delano. Spencer Dingle. Monica DeGraca Domingos. Jeremy Domino. Christine Marie Falardo. Micheline Ferguson. Stephen Vincent Fissett. Ka Heng Fong. Leticia Gonsalves de Souza. Jordan Hammer. Miguel Hernandez. Rachel Stephanie Maria Hubley. Natasha Lisa James. Kayla R. Johnson. Andrew Frederick Jordan. Jun Kang. Brendan Thomas Keane. Dasoli Kim. Brianna Marie Kathleen King. Melissa Husi Koi. Sarah Jennifer Kusar. Emily Elizabeth Cornell. Paul Lapkin. Andrew Louder. Holly Tan Lavinia. Yeah! Lin Ti Mai Lee. Samantha Lieva. Michael Lee Pretty. Lydia Marion McIntosh. Tyrone McLean Wilson. Hina Mahmood. Alan Joseph Martinez. Edwin James McLaughlin. Sophia Mitica. Nikki Modesto. Shirin Motabahari Najad. Tanuke Esther Olagundoy. Marcello Olindo. Tuba Uzkainak. Natalie Papanikolov. Vanessa Rose Peral. Ikapon Andrew Petsy. James Ragudo. Whitney Reed. Calvin Sam Reddy. Joseph Santos. Nick Savchenko. Hannah Tapang. Erica Tham. Steven Xiao. Ryan Tran. Marcel Anthony Wilson. Julie Fung Lee Wong Miu Wa. Sheena Wu. Lily Yan. Hui Ping Yu. Tianan Zhao. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Art and Design Foundation Program. Juliet Birdzik. Patrick Doyle. James Anthony Edward Floyd. Yasmin Hamill. Anil Hanasagi. George Martinez. Tracy Ellen McFadden. Ashley Nicole Merla. Talia Ortega. Carlos Salguero. McKenna May Wallowich. Yasmin Yassini. Yu Rong Zhao. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Game Development Program. John Bilocrelli. Felicia Frida Bocas. Mark Ignac Balabruch. James Raymond Briggs. Max Stanislaus Brown. Lucas David Brownell. Jonathan Reed Burton. Joseph Peter Casano. Brian DeCuto. Luis Alejandro Guyen. David Freeman Henry. Matthew Hijazi. Matthew Walter Luke. Arthur Maris. Robert Paul Martin. Harry Ng. Sean Rudy Opton Kelder. Randy Orenstein. Lawrence Pellegrini. Daryl John Podolinski. Peter Joseph Polito. Adam Paul Posavad. Warren Ripperip. Yandro Rodriguez Hernandez. Matthew Naresh Sugrim. Alexander Justin Tabone. Nao Takeda. Kristen Stephanie Tozer. Takafumi Yamazaki. Alexander Philippe Zamet. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Design Management Program. Shanila Ferheen. Irina Zurita Rendon. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Digital Design Program, Advanced Digital Design. Yi Liu. Ning Sonia Sun. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Digital Design Game Design Program. Jason Smith. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Center for Continuous Learning Education Assistant Program, Maria Antoniv. Linda Bakamian. Barbara Caballero. Donis Shaya. Lily Del Franco. Brigitte Falco. Isabella Faye Grischuk. Tina Hall. Emma Persaud. Jillian A. Russell. Eva Wincher. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the General Arts and Science Program. From the School of Liberal Studies, Alana Christine Cassells, Jessica Alexandra Gibbs, Christopher Palau, Whitney Raharja, Courtney Ann Blake. And that's from the General Arts and Science 1-year program. So pardon me, Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the General Arts and Science 1-year program. Jamie Michael Domb. Delicate Gebgo Tossa. Amanda Eve Hill. Davita LaRose. Josh Ryan Logan. Giuseppe Gianfranco Moretti. Christopher Young. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Assaulted Women's and Children's Counselor/Advocate Program. Afsar Abaji. Afra Akram. Leslie Ann Shempaglia. Shannon Marie Clark. Crystal Da Silva. Miriam Delgado. Angela Estupinian. Gilda Gomez. Brianne Hoare. Natasha Nicole Hoyt. Ashley Jex. Renata Labori. Melissa May Langford. Esther Lee. Tiana Macroni Clunis. Dorcas Irene Marty. Anna Louise Colleen Morgan. Stephanie Leah Nichos. Sedege Okovatsian. Maria Clemencia Oleye Reyes. Deborah Branco Oliveira Cruz. Iran Parsi. Kamisha Janelle Pilgrim. Jennifer Quell Cruz. Laura Simonetta. Tasha Sitamparanatham. Whitney Aaron Smith. Samantha Walker. Thank you, Madam Chancellor.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the conferring of credentials, and I'm going to ask you to join me again in congratulating the graduates. We are certainly not lacking in enthusiasm. I now invite President Ann Sato to the podium to address the graduates of the class of 2012.
Good afternoon, students and faculty, parents and friends, distinguished guests. I absolutely love the enthusiasm in this room. To the class of 2012, congratulations to all of you. You've reached the finish line of your education at George Brown, and now it's time for your victory lap. Be sure to soak in all the applause because it's truly well deserved. Convocation is my favorite part of the school year because it fills me with such pride in you, our students. Before me today, I see innovators and problem solvers, future leaders and lifelong learners. I see an auditorium full of skilled graduates about to embark on rewarding new careers, well equipped with the knowledge and training they obtained at George Brown College. There's clearly electricity in the air. For some of our graduates, this convocation marks the start of a first career. For many others, it's the second or the third. It's been said that change is the only constant in life, and that feels particularly true today. As technology evolves at lightning speed and social demands change alongside it, we're seeing entire industries reinvented. Innovation expert Jim Carroll predicts that 65% of the children in preschool today will work in jobs that don't currently exist. So if you feel that the ground is shifting underneath your feet, you're not imagining things. But I have good news for you. You've already built expertise at adapting to change. You've been building these skills during your entire academic career at George Brown, exploring new fields of study while juggling competing deadlines, heavy course loads, and family responsibilities. I'm well aware of the challenges faced by students today, but this convocation is a testament to your resilience in the face of all of these pressures. The college has been changing around you too. One of George Brown's greatest strengths is our willingness to acknowledge and embrace change in order to offer the most up-to-date training possible. We want our graduates to leave the college armed with the critical skills, knowledge, and capabilities that employers value most, and the ability to embrace change themselves so that they're ready for anything. Over the past few years, during your time at the college, we've undertaken a number of game-changing academic initiatives. I'd like to share some of those with you. They include opening our new learning facilities, such as 341 King Street, which is home to our rapidly growing video game development and design programs, as well as a gaming industry incubator. integrating a communications component into the curriculum of programs across the college. Communication skills have been identified by employers as a key ingredient for success in the workplace. An ongoing focus on increasing opportunities for field education and placements as part of all programs at the college. Growing applied research opportunities where students work with industry partners on solving real-world problems. And supporting our students and graduates with their job search by launching GB Careers, which has attracted over 7,000 registered employers since its debut. We've made these changes to ensure each one of you is graduating with both the hard and soft skills necessary to thrive in a diverse, ever-shifting work environment, because I know that's what awaits you. That doesn't mean it will be easy, but your presence here today is proof that you're ready. Class of 2012, I'd like you to think back to your first day at George Brown. Perhaps you were feeling nervous or excited or a combination of the two. I'd wager that these feelings are rising again as you think about what happens next. You selected George Brown because you had a bold, clear vision of your professional future. You've put in long hours since that first day, working hard in our classrooms and our living labs to pursue a career path that really speaks to you. You've made a commitment to your education and you stuck with it on good days and not so good days. Our staff and faculty were here to guide you along the way, but you did the work. What were the goals that kept you on track? What was the vision that inspired you? This self-reflection will come in handy as you move forward. You've laid an important foundation here at George Brown. Not only have you built up your skills and knowledge, you've also made connections, both personal and professional, that will provide encouragement and support in the years ahead. Look around. Some of your biggest advocates are here celebrating with you today, whether they're friends or family members, future colleagues, or trusted faculty. There's support available to you at the college as well. I strongly encourage you to update your information at our Alumni Relations Office so you can take advantage of the many services on offer, including professional development and job search assistance. You're part of the George Brown family now, and we're here to help. There will be many more first days ahead, new jobs, new opportunities, and new challenges. The learning doesn't stop when you walk out these doors. Apple co-founder Steve Jobs famously told a graduating class at Stanford University, "You can't connect the dots looking forward, you can only connect them looking backwards. So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future." Your graduation from college is just one of the many dots that will propel you forward into the future, and what happens next is up to you. You've walked across the stage and received your certificates and diplomas. I hope you take a moment to commend yourself on this tremendous achievement. You should be very proud. Congratulations and best of luck.
Thank you, Madam President. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the staff and faculty of George Brown College, let me congratulate the graduates and also their families, friends, and guests. Graduates, each of you here today has completed a long journey to reach this achievement. I had the opportunity of watching your smiles as you came across the stage, shaking hands with our chancellor and with our president. Along the way to today, you've had the support and encouragement of people close to you, and many of your supporters are here to celebrate with you today. So, graduates, this is your opportunity to say thank you to the parent, child, brother, sister, partner, spouse, or friend who helped make this possible. They share in your achievement. Please join me in recognizing them now.
Graduates, I also invite you to join me in expressing your thanks to the folks on the platform, to your faculty, and the staff of your center, and the college, and the other faculty who aren't here today. I would also like to thank Deborah Iafrete, Associate Registrar, and the team from the Registrar's Office for organizing this convocation. Thank you to Joanne Anderson, who provided real-time captioning for this ceremony, to Monique Ledrew and Tara Everett, our interpreters today, and to our announcer, Patrick Kwok-Chun. Special thanks also go to the staff and students from various college departments who volunteered their services today. I'd also like to thank our piper, Alex Thompson, our musicians from Lamb Chops Music, and Joseph Harper, who provided the honor song. Graduates and guests, we hope you will join us downstairs here in the Sony Center for a reception following the ceremony. We ask that you remain in the auditorium until the platform party has left the stage. I now declare these graduation exercises closed. ¶¶